Hello friends, I am Sampada Kulkarni, welcomes you in my channel Tech Talks. In this video series, I am explaining you the application of binary tree. So before moving to the content, I would like to request you to subscribe my channel Tech Talks and keep the bell ringing. So now let's start with the first application of the binary tree is expression tree. So let's start to study about expression tree. So let's introduce the expression tree, where the expression tree is a binary tree. Whenever the expression we want to express with the help of expression tree, then we can use the expression tree. So it is used to represent an expression in the binary form. So whenever the expression is there in the binary form, that we can represent with the help of expression tree. Now whenever you are going to represent the expression tree, in that case every internal node will be the operator and every leaf node of the expression tree will be the operand, just like that. So here you can see this is the internal node is operator and these are two leaf nodes, they are the operands. And in this way we can represent the expression tree. So now if I want to construct the expression tree, how I can construct the expression tree? Do I need to take the help of any another data structure? So yes, I need to take the help of stack data structure for the construction of an expression tree. If you remember, stack is also useful in the postfix and prefix expression evaluation. In the same way, for the expression construction, for the construction of expression tree, we are going to make a use of stack data structure. So let's see how to construct the expression tree from the postfix expression. For that I am going to explain you some steps that are useful for the construction of expression tree from the postfix expression. So this is nothing but my step number one, in which I'll scan a character from the postfix expression. I am having the postfix expression as an input and I'll scan the character by character from the postfix expression. What will be the step number two? In the step number two, whatever the scan character is, if it is operand, I will push that operand onto the stack directly. Then the next step, the else wala part. If it is not operand, it means that it will be an operator, because the postfix expression will be free of opening closing brackets. There will not be any opening closing bracket. This will be the combination of only operators and operands. So if it is operand, push it onto the stack. If it is operator, three sub steps we have to follow. The first sub step is we have to perform two consecutive pop operations from the stack, that whatever that popped or things or elements are there, they are nothing but the nodes of a binary tree. Then after popping two nodes, first popped node, that you have to attach it as a right child of the operator node, and second popped node, that we have to attach it as a left child of the operator node. So here we are trying to construct an expression tree for the operator, which is scan from the postfix expression. And at the end, whatever this operator node, a parent node is there, because we have attached two popped node as a right child and a left child respectively. So this operator node is going to become a parent node. So that parent node we have to push back onto the stack again. Here you have to remember that the data type of the stack will be the node structure only, because here also we are going to push the node which is holding the information part as an operand, and here also we are pushing the node whose information part is nothing but the operator, which is scanned just now from the postfix expression. So, dear friends, you must be relating all these things to the expression evaluation. Yes, these things are very same. Only the thing is that here we are going to construct a tree. Now, what will be the next step now? The next step is we have to repeat the step number 1, step number 2 and step number 3 till the end of the postfix expression. Once we will done with the postfix expression, we need to move forward for the step number 5, and it is nothing but stack will be holding the single element, single node, that will be the root of the expression tree. So how to apply these steps for the construction of expression tree from the postfix expression, these things with the solved example I am going to explain you in the next video. For the same, I request you to stay tuned with my channel Tech Talks. So thank you friends for listening and watching this video. If you like the content and the video, please do not forget to give the comment and do not forget to share it with your friends. Here I am providing you a shortcut link for the subscription of my channel Tech Talks, and I am providing you a shortcut link for the next video of this video series, and the whole video series also I am providing here in the form of playlist. So thank you. Happy data structuring, happy learning. Thank you.